So, now what we try to find out is what is the effect of temperature and pressure on these reactions, okay, first, good, yeah. So, what do you think, I mean how this temperature and pressure is affecting the rates, because again here we need rate of reaction, right, but unfortunately this time rate of reaction depends on temperature as well as concentration. So, now we have to find out what is the effect of the temperature on the rate, right. Okay, whether you have if it is equilibrium, it is much worse, the effect will be very, very drastic. So, that is why we have to now discuss those things, right. So, you just take this equilibrium composition, comma, rate of reaction and product distribution are affected by changes in operating temperature, that is one point. Okay, what is this product distribution? I think you understand equilibrium composition, will it change with temperature?
Yes.
Rajeshri is thinking.
It
is a function of temperature, so it affects. Then what about rate of reaction? I think that should be immediate louder answer, I say. Yes, like that. Okay, that rate of reaction affected by temperature, I think LKG kid will tell. Okay, then what is the product distribution getting affected? What do you mean by product diffusion? Yield, depending on activation energies, then you will have some reaction preferred, some reaction not preferred and all that. So, even your product distribution for multiple reactions is also affected by this temperature, affected by temperature. Then what are other things that can get affected? Point number 2, selectivity, product distribution will come in selectivity and all that. Yeah, product distribution is a general word. Any other thing which can affect temperature effects? Call, all files they are stored, just call, search the files. Activation energy is supposed to be independent of temperature, yeah, something connected to that only you have to tell. Search all the files, mind. Rate constant, first one, rate of reaction affected means that is the only one, concentration, rate of reaction affected means concentration will come, temperature will come.
Heat of reaction,
delta H or also will get affected by temperature. So, the next point is that heat effects during reaction which determine heat requirement and exchange of heat, okay. Also affected by temperature. Okay, so these two are most important things, and in fact, the entire economics depend on these two, the temperature, how it is affecting the rate, equilibrium conversion. You see, equilibrium conversion, one case where equilibrium conversion falls with the temperature, which case is that? Equilibrium conversion falls or decreases with the temperature, which exothermic? Not all exothermic reactions. Reversible exothermic
reactions
will have lower and lower conversions when you have higher and higher temperatures. Now you see the economics will depend on that. So if I take, okay, temperature is very good, so I go to very high temperature, then conversion I will get 1%, right? So I am not able to convert more, the plant it cannot produce more. So, that is why it may go into the losses. So, or otherwise what you have to do is you have to put another distillation column, separate this 1% and then remaining 99% you have to say, but not in the sense of recycled reactor. Please, yeah, that is why you are telling that to increase the conversion, sir, we use recycled reactor. So, that is not recycle, in fact, you are only separating the reactants and products, and reactants are again sent back to, yeah, for the reaction to be carried out, that is all, but not as in the sense of recycle reactor. Recycle reactor, you are mixing the recycle product with the fresh stream, there you are making this one itself as fresh stream. Okay? So, that is why many of you get confused why recycle reactor, more efficient than all other reactors, because that is the question. No? When I asked you, most of you wrote that recycle reactor when it is used means, when you need more conversions, you will never get more conversions there, you will get always less conversions than plug flow, right. Okay, good. So that is the one. Then from thermodynamics, we have to now calculate heat absorbed or heat released, and also we have to now discuss equilibrium conversions, these two, and we have the equations. That is why quickly, very briefly, we will give these equations. That is heat liberated or consumed. So that means this is exothermic reaction, this is endothermic reaction. Yeah, that is one case where, let us take that, I think a specific reaction AA going to R plus S plus S. This is the reaction. Okay. So now I want to calculate delta HR for this. What is the equation? Delta HR equal to delta HR naught at some standard temperature, then plus T0 to T del Cp into dT. Okay. What, Harishankar, closed? Not writing at all. Why, you don't like the equations or what? Okay. So this is the equation where del equal to R Cpr plus S Cps minus A Cp Cpa, where Cps are specific heats. I think you know that, right? Yeah. So then here also I have to say that delta HR, delta HR negative means what? Delta HR positive means, so this is exo, this one is endo, that is the conversion. That means if I give minus delta HR equal to, let us say 10,000, minus delta HR equal to, that is exothermic reaction. And on the other hand, if I give delta HR equal to 10,000, that is endothermic reaction. That is the convention. Okay, different books may follow differently, but that is the convention. Okay. And also we know that Cpa also is a function of Cps. All these also functions of temperature, alpha A plus beta A T plus gamma A T square. We are stopping only with square. Okay. So then this one is alpha R plus beta R T plus gamma R T square, this is 4. Then this will be alpha S beta S T plus gamma S T square, this is 5, right? This is from thermodynamics, we know this. So then actually I have to substitute all this in this and then calculate what is delta HR at the required temperature at which I am conducting the reaction. So I may give you delta HR naught at 25 degrees is so much, and I can give the temperature is happening maybe around 500 degrees centigrade. Then if I give all these values, you have to substitute here and then integrate and then finally calculate delta HR at 500 degrees centigrade. Okay. That is what is the actual heat that is released. Okay. Good. So I will also give this integral integrated expression. So if I have delta HR equal to delta HR naught plus T naught to T, we have delta alpha plus delta beta T plus del gamma T square dT. which after integration gives me delta H R naught, delta. T minus T naught plus beta by 2 T minus or square T 0 square plus del gamma by 3 T cube minus T 0 cube. Yeah, this is equation number 6. This is equation number 7. Okay, so this is delta H r. Where again I have to write del alpha. What is del alpha equal to? R alpha r plus S alpha s minus A alpha a. Del beta equal to, I am sure most of you switched off your brains, S beta S minus A beta A, capital A. Del gamma equal to R gamma R plus S gamma S minus A gamma A. So, this is 8, 9, 10. I am not giving any explanation how you got and all that, but anyway it is straightforward. You have to substitute there, integrate and then group out all those things like this, then you will get the simple form of equation. Dels are normally used only to minimize the space and minimize the writing. Okay? So, that is why this is the one. Good. So, now the next one what we have to also think is the equilibrium conversions. Okay? So, this is one and second one is equilibrium conversions. Equilibrium conversion. So, what is the equation normally we use? Dt equal to delta H r by r t square. What is this equation? Yeah, Pentorf's equation. And once you integrate this, what do you get? Ln k 1 by k 2, because this is equilibrium k. So, k 1 by k 2, if I have forward reaction and backward reaction, equal to minus delta H r by r 1 by t minus 1 by t naught in our sense here. Okay, this is equation 12. Good. How is this equilibrium conversion, how do you get here? So, I have not told anything about equilibrium conversion, but I gave this equation. K 1 by K 2 is related to, because this is nothing but forward reaction by backward reaction. So, in a simplest sense, when you have A going to R reversibly. So, then what is the equilibrium conversion?
K 1 is equal to 1 minus x a by 1 minus
in terms of x a, x a e by 1 minus
x
a. I think all that you remember, hopefully. Okay. Capital K equal to x a e by 1 minus x a e, and you should know how you got it. Okay. Good. Very good.
So, there is a reversible reaction also. So, like how can you write del C p as product minus reactant, there will be some equilibrium conversion also.
What is that you are talking? This is different, that is different.
But HR you have taken from there.
This HR, okay, yeah. Your problem of this one, yeah. Here when you are doing it, we take delta HR as constant.
But this HR you have produced from that equation.
Yeah.
So understood. In that equation, we assume it is 100%.
It is a function of temperature. Right?
So, over there, we assume it is 100% conversion.
That's not
reversible. It is 100% conversion.
Because Cp you took as R product minus.
No. 100% conversion we have not. That is the total delta HR. Okay. So this is the that is true. That is at the end. I think it is only 100% conversion, right? So you write for that. But in the actual one, how do you calculate how much heat released? That maximum delta HR minus, not minus, into minus RA.
Number of mole present at any time.
Stoichiometric coefficients, final stuff, really. Any time when you are.
Will it be valid if the reaction is not going to be completed, whatever?
Yeah, definitely. Because whatever conversions you get at any point of time, it is only stoichiometric proportions only. You cannot have any other. That is the beauty in stoichiometry, no? It is only the stoichiometric proportions only will react, will result finally the products, okay? Yeah. So that is why that is not a problem. But in this equation, what we have assumed is that delta HR is not a function of temperature. Not only in this, in most of the chemical engineering calculations, we assume that delta HR is not a function of temperature. That is justified. Yeah.
If you assume it's a function of temperature, then we will not integrate delta HR.
Yes. Mathematically, it will be very, very complicated. But normally in engineering, we do not do that at all, because our reactions in any reactor happening over a small range. Even if you have a non-isothermal, from inlet to the outlet, maximum you may have some 100 degree centigrade or 50 degree centigrade. Okay? Over that, whether how much it is affecting, that is what you have to check. That means at inlet temperature, what is the delta HR? At outlet temperature, what is the delta HR? If that variation is not much, then you assume that delta HR is constant. But as an engineer, what we also do is, even if there is not very, very substantial change, but reasonable change, then what do? I will take the arithmetic average of these two and then say that my temperature, my delta HR is reasonable over this, I am constant over this range of operation. Otherwise, it is only mathematically complicated. If you want to do, you can do it, right? But only thing is mathematically complicated. So that is why. Okay, Abhishek? Yeah. So that is why delta HR is calculated for final one only, right? And then delta HR multiplied by, you know, minus RA. What are the units of delta HR? Kilocalories or kilojoules per mole. Then I have to find out, you know, what is the rate of release. How do you calculate that? Multiplied by minus RA, what you will give, what do you get? Yeah, kilojoules per or kilo calories per second per meter. So now that is why that volume element also will come later. Minus RA into dV small v if I take plug flow reactor, or if I take mixed flow reactor, it is total V. Okay? So that will tell me how many calories or how many kilojoules per second released. Okay? That is the rate of heat released, right? Good. So if it is exothermic reaction, knowing that this much heat is released, now my process requirement tell me how much I have to remove out of that. Okay? If you completely remove, the temperature will fall and then again conversions may be less, depending on the reaction I am telling. Okay? Sometimes less, sometimes more. So that is the reason why I also told you in the beginning, you know, economics will depend on this, how much you have to cool, how much you have to heat. And also delta HR also, we need that information, because that will also determine what is the temperature in the system, correct? No? If there is too much delta HR, definitely temperature is going to increase if it is exothermic reaction. If it is too much endothermic also delta HR, then temperature will fall very rapidly, then you will have very, very low conversions, rate of reaction equal to almost zero. Okay? So this is additional parameter which automatically comes into picture when you are talking about temperature effects. Okay? Good. So that is the one. And now we will just summarize few points about the thermodynamic information that is required for reactor design. Thermodynamic information required for, please write that, thermodynamic information required for reactor design. In terms of points, we will go one by one. Lewenspiel beautifully summarized all these. Okay? Yeah. Now let us take those points and discuss. Point number one, thermodynamic equilibrium constant is unaffected by the pressure of the system, comma, by the presence or absence of inerts, comma, or by the kinetics of the reaction, comma, but is affected by the temperature of the system. How it is affected also we will draw here. So, this is XAE thing saying that, that means A is our key component. Okay. So, this is temperature, this is maximum conversion, that is 1. So, now if it is exothermic, you will have like this. If it is endothermic, have like this. Okay. This is exo. Exothermic, and this is endothermic. Okay. Yeah, point number 2, though the thermodynamic equilibrium constant is unaffected by pressure or inerts, comma, the equilibrium concentration of materials and equilibrium conversion of reactants can be influenced by these variables. Point number 3, we will discuss, you know, once you note down one by one, we will discuss later. Okay. Point number 3, k far greater than 1 indicates that practically complete conversion may be possible and that the reaction can be considered to be irreversible. Excellent, we will stop there. Okay. K far less than 1, next sentence, k far less than 1 indicates that reaction will not proceed to any appreciable extent, that is in the direction what we want. Okay. Number 4, for an increase in temperature, equilibrium conversion rises for endothermic reactions and drops for exothermic reactions. I am telling all this because this can be one of my separate tests. Yeah, all these 6 points you have to write, you know, 2 more will come. Yeah, next one. Number 5, for an increase in pressure in gas phase reactions, conversion rises when number of moles decreases with reaction, semicolon, conversion drops when the number of moles increases with reaction. Okay, good. Number 6 is, a decrease in inerts for all reactions acts in the way that an increase in pressure acts for gas phase reactions. Now, what is the meaning of number 1, point number 1? Because in fact, all these things is beautiful summary of thermodynamics that is required for reactions. There are many other things, you know, for energy and all that there, but for reactions, wonderful points, wonderful summary. The thermodynamic equilibrium constant is unaffected by the pressure, inerts, okay, and also the kinetics, kinetics also, but only thing is it is a function of temperature. Okay, that we should know, that is number 1. Number 2 is, though the thermodynamic constant is unaffected by pressure and inerts, but the equilibrium compositions will change. That is why we add sometimes, you know, diluents and all that to shift the reaction for conversion from one side to the other side, right. So, temperature affects only thermodynamic equilibrium, but compositions, that means the conversions, okay. Yeah, the actual composition, that is Ca, Cb, Cr, Cs, those things will be affected by again inerts, okay. Yeah, that is point number 2. Good. What is point number 3? Very simple. K is far greater than 1, it is almost irreversible reaction. That means, yeah. So, almost here K, you may get almost 100% reaction. Okay. This is K far greater than 1.
Sir, does this mean if you give me Gibbs free energy, I can tell it is reversible or irreversible without conducting experiments?
That is what our first classes we discussed. Okay. Depending on, you know, how do you know that first of all the reaction is occurring? Depending on Gibbs free energy, you can, because Gibbs free energy again is connected with K.
Minus
ln K. So, if K is very large, you know, you calculate,
so
Gibbs
conducting reaction itself, I can tell it is reversible.
Yeah, of course.
Exactly. Rahul, that is what I think, you know, the first few questions what we have discussed there. How does a chemical process start? In that, the first step is to find out whether the reaction is feasible or not. How? Go to delta G, Gibbs free energy, calculate delta G from, you know how to calculate. But you should know the stoichiometric equation. If you have stoichiometric equation like that, you have the tables where for the components that free energy G is listed. Okay. From there calculate delta G. I think that is very good. Once more I can repeat, because some of you still would have not got that idea. Right. Calculate delta G, that is equal to minus RT ln K, but you have to assume a T. For particular T, what is K? Right. So, depending on that K value, you can say that whether it is reversible, irreversible, all kinds of things we can interpret from that. Okay, good. So that is the one. So the next one is we are now trying to discuss about the graphical design of non-isothermal reactors. The graphical design, that means from we are not going to get exactly the quantitative numbers like okay volume of this is 10 meter cubed, but the procedure for you know the graphical analysis, that is what we are going to discuss now.
System provided the time is infinite, any reacting system provided the time is infinite, can I do that?
Please repeat again, what is that
like, can I
time
write
coming here?
Equilibrium model, say a time equal to infinity, like reaction will eventually.
Where is time coming here? Because if I know the k value is very, very large, then it is irreversible. Okay, if the k is maybe you know,
so reaction will go to completion ultimately.
That's all.
Yeah.
What you can get from that, if time will not come here.
Okay, so I'm asking about the model. If I write an equilibrium model for a reacting system,
what is equilibrium? Is it reaction equilibrium or you are talking about something else?
Reaction equilibrium.
Reaction equilibrium, you don't have to talk about.
For irreversible reaction also, can I write?
For irreversible reaction, what do you want to write? Tell me. What is that you want to write?
Like model of the.
What model?
Either kinetic model or equilibrium model.
What kinetic model?
Yeah. Kinetic model is conversion at given time. Sir, I'll ask you something.
No. What kinetic model you are telling? For example, I have a batch reactor, first order reaction, and I know the equation. What is the equation for design? Because I have written my model equations and then got okay for plug flow, k tau equal to k tau equal to, let me write that, k tau p equal to minus ln 1 minus x a. So which one you are talking here? Because this equation I got only by writing the model equation, that means what is entering, what is leaving and all that, but this is for isothermal system what you are writing.
Irreversible reaction also.
You cannot make equilibrium assumption for the reactor.
No, I am considering the reaction is like very fast and irreversible. Still I can go for equilibrium model.
What is the use? Because still you can
without
write the
kinetics, I can go
because x anyway for irreversible you can get 90% conversion, 99% conversion, right? But when you have reversible reaction, that will limit. It will tell you, fellow, you cannot go to 99%, you can only go to 60% at that temperature. So it is always associated with the temperature. So that is why in Gibbs free energy you will get temperature versus conversion graph also you can plot. That is what is the meaning of this in fact. When I am operating exothermic reaction at very low temperatures, this is the conversion I can get, equilibrium conversion. But the disadvantage of operating at very low conversion here, the rate of reaction itself will be very, very low. XA you can get that much, but the rate is very, very low. This is thermodynamic information. Okay? So, equilibrium conversion almost 1 means I can also get actual conversion almost 1, but how much time I have to wait? Because there it is not equilibrium coming, it is only the rate of reaction coming. When the temperature is very, very, very low, then the rate of reaction is not very fast. Right? So, that is why my reactor will be very, very big, because I have to provide that much residence time for the reaction to take place. Okay? So, I think that question of writing a model for equilibrium model for irreversible reaction, it will not come into picture at all. As far as I know, it won't come into picture. What is exactly your, not able to understand, because something must be worrying you, something must be bothering you. So what is that point? Okay. So you see, I think maybe some of you also may have the same doubts there. What we do here is that if I know from Gibbs free energy, I will find out capital K value, that will decide whether I have irreversible or reversible, right? Irreversible, I can go to any conversion, but only thing is depending on the temperature and you know what conversion, that means volume of the reactor may be more sometimes. I told you, sometimes from 0.9 to 0.95, the volume may be triple or maybe to make four times. From 0.95 to 0.96, 97, 98, the volume will be tremendously increasing. So, economics will tell you, fellow, do not go beyond this, otherwise all money will go only for constructing the reactor. So, then I think it is a problem, do not go like that. Again, economic analysis. that is one thing, but that is irreversible. The moment I have reversible reaction, now I know at what temperature I am going to conduct, that we should know, at what temperature we are going to conduct the reaction. Now, let us say 150 degrees I am going to conduct the reaction, that will automatically fix my equilibrium conversion. If 150 is somewhere here, that is what is the equilibrium conversion for irreversible, for reversible exothermic reaction. Beyond that, no one can do. That is why I feel many times, you know, thermodynamics is God, because that tells you, you cannot go beyond this. That is what God also tells you. He won't directly tell you, but through other some other systems, he will tell, okay, that I think only you can get a maximum this degree, beyond that you cannot get. Whatever you try, you cannot get that degree, I tell you. Okay, if your life is written only like, okay, M.Tech is the maximum degree, you may join PhD, something will happen, you have to leave and then go back. That is the God's law, that's all, that is the point, beyond that you cannot cross. Exactly the thermodynamics also will tell you, XAE, here only 60%, you can never cross that. But sometimes we cheat, we have what is called process intensification. If it is a reversible reaction, then what we do is, we will take out the product, so that only always it is forward reaction. So, forward reaction alone means very good, I mean I can increase the conversions. So, that is cheating also is there, we also cheat sometimes, no? So, you may not get a degree from IIT Madras, you may buy one from many places, correct, no? There are many places who are selling PhD degrees, yeah, and then you are very happy, I got the degree, okay, even though God said you cannot do it, he said only you cannot do it, not get it, okay. Okay. Range of for reversible reactions, around 1, 2, 3, you can't tell, even 0.5, okay. So, that again automatically that K value, whatever you get from the reaction itself, that depends on the temperature, it will be fixed by temperature limit, right, beyond certain temperature, slightly that flexibility is there with you. You can conduct the temperature over 50 degrees, okay. So, beyond that, or maybe 100 degrees, depending on each case, but we cannot generalize that K must be only this value for a reversible reaction, we can never, right. And the example which I gave earlier asked, you know, K equal to XAE by 1 minus XAE. If K equal to 1, what is the equilibrium conversion?
0.5.
That's all, you cannot go beyond that. So, like that, okay. So, but that is also fixed at one temperature, right, because K changes with some other temperature. So, that is all. That is only, you cannot fix exactly what is this value must be like this. That depends on the process, type of reaction, materials of construction, many, many things will come into picture. Okay, Abhishek, not able to get. What is that? That K will be 10,000.
Yeah, so there will be K value.
That K only I am telling, that K is 10,000. That you got already K, but only thing is that K equal to K1 by K2, this K equal to K1 by K2. So, what is the meaning of 10,000? The backward reaction is almost 0, that is why we are telling that it is irreversible, it is only going for one direction. You got already that, right? The K value, are you talking about equilibrium constant or rate constant? There is equilibrium constant, which is a very large value, because Gibbs free energy, when you calculate and then get very large value, that means there is a K value. If you have stoichiometry and if you have the components, those components have that G values, you can calculate, and then when you calculate, you will get, let us say, 20,000. So, your idea is, okay, my forward reaction is very, very large, I mean very fast, and my backward reaction is very, very small. So, this is theoretically irreversible, reversible reaction, but practically it is irreversible. You have K value, you got K
value.
There is no purely irreversible, there is no purely irreversible.
Sir, no, I am just telling the ideal case.
Yeah, that means, you know, you will have purely irreversible, K2 equal to 0, you will get infinity. Yeah, okay, that is purely theoretically, right. So, that is why what we are taking there is that the forward reaction is very, very large when compared to backward reaction. That is why, you know, there is one statement that all reactions are reversible, correct, no? Yeah. So, then depending on the value of k, you decide whether you have, and as Abhishek asked, we cannot fix what is the value for k, capital K, right. But you can specify temperature, automatically capital K is fixed because k 1, k 2. You can also get in a different way. You can actually conduct kinetic expressions, get k 1 value, get k 2 value, and also at a given temperature again, you can also get k. That is to check your thermodynamics as well as kinetics. Not able to understand. Okay, good. Yeah. So, the next one is the graphical design for isothermal reactors. What is the graphical design? Okay, I think non-isothermal reactors are there. Graphical design. Yeah. For isothermal, you tell me. Non-isothermal is just above.
1 by minus R.
Yeah. So, 1 by minus R A versus? X A. But what is the problem here, or what is the problem that is going to be here?
More than one.
You have now another variable.
Temperature.
Now, temperature. Now, you have to draw actually three-dimensional. Okay. So, again we cheat there. Instead of drawing three-dimensional graph, what do you do? We fix one parameter
and we vary,
and then draw the
other two.
That is all. So, because I have three here, what are the three? I have rate, temperature, okay, R, okay, rate, my R is looking awkward, okay, rate, even now may be awkward, X A. These are the three. So, for isothermal, it is easy for me because I think this fellow will be sleeping. So, these two only will be active. So, we plot. So, because there are three now, you can draw a three-dimensional graph. Three-dimensional graphs we cannot understand. Okay. So, that is why we better go for two-dimensional graph by fixing. Yeah. See, many times we say parameter. What is the difference between a parameter and a variable? Parameter will be constant. Variable will be variable. That is what the meaning, what is the meaning?
In the same,
we have
different
parameters.
So parameter
is a constant. Yeah, tell me, what is parameter there?
Which parameter?
It is one value.
We are fixing one value.
Yeah, I think, you know, the variables are shown in the X and Y, parameters are shown as fixed numbers, and then only for that number, for that value, particular value, you see the behavior, and then again increase or decrease, and then see how the behavior is changing. That is only for cheating, you know, because we cannot understand the three-dimensional graphs. That is why what we are doing here. Now, we can also plot here the graphs, like this is minus R A versus minus R A versus temperature, I can plot. Good. Similarly, I can also plot R versus X A, and we can also plot X A versus temperature. So, here R will be parameter, and here temperature will be parameter, and here X A will be parameter. So, any one of these things we can choose, okay. But normally what we choose is, yeah, in fact, if you plot minus R A versus temperature, general graphs you may have like this, like this, like this. This may be X 1, X A 1, X A 2, X A 3, X A 3. So, in this case R versus, R versus X for different temperatures, you may get something like this, this is T 1, T 2, T 3, just I am showing, you know, some general graphs. Or otherwise, if I plot X versus T, you may get like this, So, this will be minus R A 1 minus R A 2 minus R A 3. These are the three different graphs you get, but what actual type of graphs you get we can also derive. That is what I am going to do. Okay, good. Anyway, I think tomorrow we will meet. And see, actually we have not covered much in non-isothermal. So, that is why this also can be included in the examination.